Hi, my name is Gary Raposa, and I'm an application engineer here at Agilent Technologies, soon to be Keysight Technologies. I'm here today to talk to you about our AC sources and how they can be used to test power adapters. I have some examples of power adapters right here, some small ones such as one for an iPhone or an iPad, all the way up to some larger power adapters like this one, which would be used for a docking station for a laptop where many other peripherals would be plugged in as well, hence the higher power. So many of these adapters are used in various countries. For example, here in the United States, we have 120 volts at 60 hertz. In Europe, it's 230 volts AC at 50 hertz. And these adapters have to be able to be used in all those various countries around the entire world. Now that's where the AC source comes in handy, to test the adapters. The output of the AC source can be set to anywhere between 0 volts all the way up to 270 volts and at frequencies from 40 hertz to 500 hertz. So we can easily accommodate with these AC6800 AC sources all of the various input voltages and frequencies that power adapters use. So as an example, this particular adapter can be used in countries throughout the entire world. In fact, the specifications on it say it can be used from 100 volts AC up to 240 volts and at frequencies from 50 hertz to 60 hertz. So it's very easy to test this particular adapter and these other ones using the AC sources that we have, because we can set it to any of those voltages in order to test that input range on the adapter itself. So I'd like to show you even a specific example using this charger for a reciprocating saw. Got the battery here, and the charger's plugged into the output of the AC source, and I know that I can set this for 120 volts. I have this set for 120 volts, 60 hertz, which is the nominal input for here. So I'll turn that on. And it comes on as you would expect, and the LED indicators show the state of charge of the battery. But the LED indicators can also show you one other thing. It says on the front panel here, it has a problem power line indication. So if all three come on and flash twice and then go off and flash twice and then go off, that means there's a problem with the power line. So in order to test that feature of this charger, I can bring the voltage down on the output of the AC source. So let's try 88 volts, 88, enter, and I can see that the three LEDs are flashing in the proper indication to show that there is in fact a problem with the power line. So we've been able to demonstrate that the AC source is capable of providing the right input to test all the various features on this particular charger. So I also want to show you some of the measurement features that are built into this AC source. I still have the power adapter for the reciprocating saw battery hooked up, and I have the output set for 120 volts, and you can see the current being drawn is about 1.3 amps, and it's varying a little bit, probably because there's some pulsing going on for the battery. But there's other measurements built in as well. There's another screen here where we get watts and VA and power factor, and it's pulling anywhere from down at a couple of watts. Looks like it just went to full charge, so it's only down at 2 watts. But again, it's changing around a bit, up to 100 or even 150 watts. And if I hit meter button again here, there's other measurements that are being made as well. One I'll draw your attention to here very quickly is this amps peak and hold measurement. It's about 20 amps, so the inrush current to this particular adapter charging this battery was about 20 amps. And we also have the ability built into the AC source to change the phase angle at which the output turns on, the output of the AC source. So you can see what the peak inrush current is and how it varies with a phase turn on of the AC source itself. So in conclusion, if you are testing the universal AC input on power adapters, We've seen that the Agilent AC6800 series is a really great product to help you do that. Thank you for watching.